tracking Deborah Amajid from Silicon Valley to get back to that conversation and round off this discourse around ICTS bringing Silicon Valley to Nigeria. Good morning and welcome to the program, Deborah. It's good to have you now on Skype. Deborah, can you hear me? Okay, I think we're not getting that. That's a bit very patchy, Ellie, today. But let's look at what is going to be on the program today for the Nigerian Stock Exchange, the final Monday in the new year. That's the 29th. The U.S. Consul General John Bray is the one who will be closing the market for this Monday, for today, and he will be speaking to the market on the cooperation between the United States and the Nigerian economy, and it will speak to the state of the market and the support that the U.S. authorities were providing the Nigerian market. Today is also the day the Nigerian Stock Exchange is rolling out the new par value of stocks and setting a new price limit, recategorize the stocks according to price, creating Group C, roll out what we'll call the limit of transactions that are the size of the pack you need to move a particular stock. You hear that the new price value or new par value will no longer be 50 kobo, officially speaking, and that the prices of these stocks will be allowed to find a new level, could go as low as 1 kobo on the Nigerian Stock Exchange. So we'll be looking at this tomorrow on the program. But let's remind you, where we finished off last week, the market was almost 3%, 2.93% in the red. A very decent week, however, in terms of turnover, 7.15 billion ordinary shares in the week for 42.54 billion naira in almost 40,000 transactions. Investors book a lot of profit. If you started the show with us, you heard where that came from. In particular, some of those banks trading around par value, whose investors are crop some profits last week, Diamond Bank, Fidelity, and around Skybank as well. Some of those lenders were part of the 6.4% negative landing we had on the NSE last week. The consumer goods was up, however, last week, 2.15%. Again, the news this morning about Nigerian breweries listing about 70 billion new ordinary shares on the market. Then industrial goods was down by 2%. Dangote led that cement lender to the south. Insurance followed their cousins, the banks, to the negative territory, 3.33%. Oil and gas was a decent 0.08%, as we see investors making a bit of a comeback on Friday. Forte Oil was unchanged, but Double One PLC, which was mobile, gained 3.35%. Seplat, which is the only EMP on the market, gained 1.11% again because of the rally that we saw last week in the price of crude oil, briefly at $71 a barrel, went down a little bit to 70 and still now around 69.50 per barrel. Eternal Oil, which is a small cap in that space, was 5% positive on Friday. That gave the oil and gas segment of our market a soft landing on Friday, when that was 0.08%. You heard the story about the fixed income space earlier. We have a lot more to talk about for the rest of this week. Keep your eyes on Business Morning. Keep your eyes on Channels Television, Nigeria's news leader. I'll see you tomorrow.